get saved, because then you won't. And I got saved and kept on doing. So then where am I supposed to go? Because apparently Jesus doesn't work for me. He goes, oh, no. We'll work through this. But I'm not letting you go in the meantime. Oh, we'll get there. I'll finish it. I started it. I'll be faithful to finish. Don't give up. Keep walking. Keep pressing in. Keep confessing. But don't give up. I'll heal you. I won't let you go. There is no one who can condemn you. I don't. And if I don't, no one can. Who will even bring a charge against you? You're mine. What court could they possibly charge you in? Everything's mine.
He is jealous for me. Love's like a hurricane. I am a tree bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me. And oh, how he loves us. Oh, oh, how he loves us. How he loves us.
That God in eternity looked upon me, foreseeing my fallenness, my pride, my sin, and said, I want that man in my family. I would do anything to get him in my family. I will pay for him to be in my family with my son's life. That's love, folks. That is mega, off the charts love.
He is jealous for me. Love's like a hurricane. I am a tree bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me. And oh, how he loves us. Oh, oh, how he loves us.
Why? Because he loves you. Because he loves you. That's why. We've got this weird compartmentalization thing that happens where you don't think that God sees all that you are, or that if he could have somehow knew who you were going to be, he wouldn't have gone to the cross. Listen, God knew you were going to be messy. Christ knew that you were going to be messy. God knows that you're going to screw up often. He knows that you're going to be drawn to things that are wicked. He knows that's what the cross is all about. It's the whole point of the cross, is that you're going to fail and you're going to stumble and you're going to feel dirty and you're going to feel awkward. The whole point of the cross of Christ is there be this mighty picture of his love and pursuit of you despite you. So the cross is necessary because of you, but it's also the picture we have of just how far God is willing to go because he loves you.
Time to maintain its address when I think about the way. I'm not bitter against the church. I just think somehow we've got off, and there's all this talk about morality, and people are conforming themselves to these moral codes, but they don't know Jesus. Who cares? It's the resurrection of Christ that justifies. That's why it's so important. That's why it's so big. It proves that all the wrath of God was poured out. It's gone. For the elect, it's gone. There is no more wrath. There's none. So Jesus sees you and he's like, my son, my daughter, perfect, spotless, blameless.
Oh, how he loves us.